By the end of Revenge of the Sith, Darth Vader was left in disarray. He'd lost his love, his beloved Jedi Order, and a sizable portion of his body confined in the iconic cybernetic suit. But what did Vader do right after this chain of tragic events?
Is she all right?
It seems in your anger, you killed her.
I couldn't have. She was alive. I felt it.
So, Vader is released from the confines of the medical bay where he was integrated into his suit, and you can imagine he's pretty annoyed after he learns of Padme's death. Remember, this is the entire reason he joined the dark side and did those unspeakable acts, and to be more precise, he's angry at Sidious. It's him who said he could save Padme and he didn't. So Vader tries to kill him, attempting to force choke the decrepit Sith Lord. However, this fails, it has no effect on Sidious, who somehow knows how to block this. As you can imagine, Sidious doesn't respond well to this and barrages his new apprentice with Force Lightning, causing immense pain and highlighting how Sidious is Vader's superior. He warns Vader never to attempt such an act again, also mockingly telling him to use his lightsaber to block the stream, knowing that he'd lost it during his duel with Obi-Wan on Mustafar. Sidious then reminded him that it was not his lightsaber lost on Mustafar, but one belonging to Anakin Skywalker, a Jedi who was no more. Vader is reminded that his former life and everything that came with it is gone, and he serves Sidious now. The two then made haste to the ruins of the Jedi Temple, where Sidious had arranged a ceremony to take place, in which all of the Jedi's lightsabers had been rounded up and were being thrown into a furnace and destroyed. Vader and Sidious watched from a concealed balcony. Again, this was probably an attempt by Sidious to cement his control over Vader, remind him of what he had done to come this far, and that there was no going back, the Order was destroyed. Vader was shown the early framework of the Death Star alongside Moff Wilhuff Tarkin, before being sent to Murica, a separatist stronghold which was held by the Corporate Alliance during the Clone Wars. Vader would be sent across the galaxy to stomp out separatist holdouts and Jedi remnants wherever they would hide. Finally, he was re-given command over the 501st Clone Legion, the old detachment that Anakin Skywalker had commanded during the Clone Wars. This legion, infamous for the role they played in Operation Nightfall, served alongside Vader faithfully. Even when the clones were phased out, their ranks were replaced with normal, Imperial citizens, some of whom Vader would personally train to ensure only the strongest served alongside him. So ruthless were the 501st tactics and means, they gained the nickname Vader's Fist. Vader was elevated to a high role in Sidious's new Imperial regime, however was not part of its military or navy. He served Sidious directly. This gained the mistrust of many Imperial commanders who were jealous of his raised position, despite no evidence of how it was achieved. Vader went on to carry all manner of the Empire's notorious deeds on behalf of his sinister master, constantly being reminded of the unspeakable acts that he had committed to get there. I hope you enjoyed the video, if so, please remember to like and sub for more Star Wars content, and follow me on Twitter at TheLoreGuy for regular updates. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.